We got to Henley about 10 in the morning. Had a pleasant time walking along the riverbank, kicking all the picnic hampers into the river. Several people had spent the night overnight on various rich yachts, which they'd pillaged. I mean, it was typical class war action. There wasn't any major set piece. It was jostling, spitting, telling people they weren't welcome, telling them that, you know, we were going to be there, we were going to get over to the bridge, we were going to eat their strawberries and cream, we were going to burn the tent down, we were going to fuck them over, we were going to drop bombs on their boats when they went under the fucking bridge. The classic class war line was, when you look out of your windows, we'll be there. When you drive down the streets in your Rolls Royces, we'll be there. We have no demands to make of you. Our banners read only, behold your future executioners. When the shit goes down, you better be ready. We turned the tide a mini bit, not a lot, but the other thing about class war was it was a fucking good laugh while it lasted.
The attacks on expensive shops and cars bore the hallmarks of what one of the groups, Class War, has called its Bash the Rich campaign.
The poll tax right in Trafalgar Square, the Daily Mail ran a story the day after saying that people in class war were touring the pubs offering people 20 quid to join in the riot. Let me assure the Daily Mail, no one needed any fucking financial inducement to get involved in that riot. Class war took part in riots. We, whenever the stuff was going on that was in our air, we'd steam in and get stuck in, but we were in a very small group. We got stuck in on the same basis as anyone else did. All the lefty papers used to and still do show pictures of people who'd been beaten up by policemen, terrible, nasty policemen had beaten up poor, innocent people. And we said, well, you know, what's the fucking point writing about that? We all fucking know that's the case. What's the point bleating on like a victim about that? So Class War started Hospitalised Copper in our paper, which is one of the most popular features ever, basically showing coppers who'd been beaten up by the punters. And that was our most popular feature. We used to do a regular highlights of Hospitalised Copper calendar every year. And it was just having, you know, that was that. Why should, you know, they fuck us over every minute of our lives. Why shouldn't we ever fucking laugh when they get fucked over?
Are you getting a bit old for all this now, Ian?
Yeah, I am getting a bit on, but I think as long as you, I'll tell you what, class war is very good for your health, because if you're out there fighting away with a bit of combativity left in you, you live to be a really old age with a great deal of happiness and joy in your heart. And there's nothing to make me happy on my 89th birthday. I've seen Buckingham Palace in flames with the rest of the aristocracy doing a dance of death on the battlements. That would really cheer me up as I popped down to collect my pension.
Can I ask you about this event?
Kenya full of shit. Where were you at Henley, man? Where were you when the boys needed you?
Henley?
Shit.
What was Henley?
Huh?